Good morning, Year Four. Hope you're all okay. This is your second lesson of the week to go through your maths for today. So today we're going to be looking at perimeter of rectangles. Okay, this is something you should have covered in Year Three, but we're going to go through it again and kind of recap some of the knowledge just so we're really confident with it. Okay, so our star words are perimeter, measure, centimeter, and length. And we're going to have a look at what perimeter means in a minute, okay? So I won't expand on these star words as of yet because later on in the video we'll be going through them. So have a look at this rectangle because today we're just looking at rectangles and finding the perimeter of those kinds of shapes. What are the properties of a rectangle? Think about its sides, its corners or vertices, and have a think about whether they always look the same, they always look different. How could you work out the perimeter if you have an idea on what perimeter means? You might want to pause the video, have a think about the properties of a rectangle. So, welcome back if you've paused the video. A rectangle, as we know, has four sides. So we have four sides. We have one here, one here, one here, and one here. And we also have four corners or vertices. So we have four corners and four vertices. Now, perimeter, we're going to find out in a minute, is the distance around an object, or well, it could be an object, but a shape. And in this case, we're looking at rectangles. So the perimeter of a rectangle is going to be the length of this side, this side, this side, and this side. And you will notice with a rectangle, we have, if I do it in a different colour, these sides in green are always the same length, okay? And if I do the other ones in blue, these sides are always the same as well. And that's something that's important to remember when we're working out perimeter, and I'll tell you why later. But for now, I have a video for you to watch because I know you all love a video. I'm hoping it will work. It's just a BBC bite-sized video, but it just kind of goes through how we work out the perimeter in a nice way for you to actually see it. Okay, so I'll just pause this a minute and hopefully get the other video up and ready. So here is the BBC bite-sized video. It's not too long, so we'll watch it and then we'll have a talk about it afterwards.
How far are you going to walk today? So you're going to walk all around the outside of the park. The outside edge of a shape is called the perimeter. It's easy to know how far you're going to walk if we just measure the perimeter. How many steps does it take you to walk along the first side? 10 steps, right. And how many steps does it take to walk around the next side? 6 steps, okay. Now do the next side. 10 steps again, yes? And now back to where you started? 6. So how far is it to go all the way around? All we need to do is add the numbers from each of the sides together, and then we know how far it is all the way around. So 10 plus 6 plus 10 plus 6 equals 32. You'll walk for 32 steps if you go all the way around the perimeter.
So hopefully that video kind of went through it in a bit more detail and you were able to see how we actually work out perimeter using our addition knowledge that we've already looked at this year. So I'm going to show you a rectangle and we're going to work out the perimeter together, okay? So this grid, we're going to pretend that each square is a centimeter wide, okay? It's not actually, but for the sake of this, we're just going to do it. So it's not to scale. So let's count how many squares down it would be. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we know that it's 6 centimeters this side. Let's go down the bottom. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's 4 centimeters wide that way. Now, as I said before, on a rectangle, the opposite sides are always the same. Okay, so if we know that this side's 6, we don't need to count this side because we know it's going to be 6 as well. The same goes for this one. Have a think what it might be. It's already on the board. Or on your screen, let's say, not the board. So it would be 4 because we know that it's going to be the same as this one. Okay, and we can check it if you're not too sure. Double check it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we know that's 6 and 1, 2, 3, 4. So we know that's 4. Now we have to add them together. Okay, so we add 6, add 4. So I'll write it here. We know that's 10. That's our number bonds. So we've done that one. That one you can cross out. And then we need to add 6 and 4 again, which is 10. And then we need to add these two answers together. So 10 add 10 is 20. So our perimeter is 20. Now remember, it's in centimetres, so we need to write the centimetres on the end. Okay, oops, sorry, that doesn't look like a C, but it is meant to be. So you could also times 10 by 2, because as you can see, we just added it twice. Now, if you wanted a shortcut, you could have just times 10 by 2, and that would have got your answer as well. Let's have a look then at this one. So now it's your turn to have a go. I want you to try and work out the perimeter of these rectangles. So I'll leave them here for you. If you want to pause the video and then try and work out the perimeter of each of the rectangles. Okay, so count the squares along one end and then the other, and then see if you can work it out. You have about 5 minutes to do it. Okay, so don't take any more than 5 minutes. Because I don't want it to be a really long task, but have a go, see how many you can work out in 5 minutes. Off you go. I hope you managed to get your perimeters done in that 5 minutes. Let's go through the answers together to see how you got on. So the first one was 12, okay, because we had 2 and 4. So we know that 2 add 4 is 6. And if you just do 6 times 2 is 12, or you could just add them up together. I don't mind either way. The bottom one is 18 centimetres. This one up here was 10 centimetres, and this is 12 centimetres. So hopefully you got them all correct. If you didn't, you might just want to go back a bit in the video just to go through it again, or maybe watch the BBC Bite Size video again, just so you're really confident and clear on it. So that's all I really have to go through with you today. It's quite a simple learning intention. Because today we're looking at it with the grid around the edge, so you can just count the squares. So you have got a mathletics task set for you now, okay? Any problems, as usual, please email me. If you get yourself a bit of a pickle or you're not too sure about it, please let me know. I will be able to see how well you do anyway. But if you're not sure and you want a bit of extra help with it, please send me a message on Microsoft Teams or get your parents to send me an email. Once you've done your mathletics, sorry about that. Once you've done your mathletics, there is also a challenge on here as well. So if you whiz through your mathletics, as usual, there is a challenge on here for you to come back and have a look at. So if you want to go do your mathletics now, and if you're coming back for the challenge, I shall see you in a minute. So welcome back. If you've come back to do the challenge, I'm about to go through the answer. So if you've not done it, pause the video again and go through it, because I am going through the answer now. So your challenge question, it says the perimeter of a rectangle is 12 centimetres. Its width is 1 centimetre. Oh, sorry about that. Explain what to do to find out its length, okay? So, as you can see, I've drawn a picture here. Now, like I've said before, I'm using a mouse, so it's not very neat, and I would expect you to do a lot better, but this is what you're getting, I'm afraid. So I drew a rectangle. And its width is 1. So I know that on either side, it's going to be 1 centimetre, because that's the width of it. I need to find out its length, okay? But I know the perimeter all around it adds up to 12. So I also use a bar model to work this out, this lovely bar model down here. So we know that 12 is the perimeter altogether. So 12 is your number that goes in the top. And then these two numbers, because it's the width, and there's two widths to it, isn't there? So we have 1 and 1. And then we need to find out this answer. So in order to find out the first step, we have to do 12, take away 1, and then take away another 1. So we're doing 12, take away 2, which I've done up here. So 12 take away 2 is 10. And then we need to divide it by another 2, because we know that 10 is the two lengths added up. So to work out one length, we'd have to divide it by 2, so it would be 5, okay? Hopefully you managed to get that. If that doesn't make sense to you and I've explained it very poorly with my not very good bar model, then let me know and I can go through it with you again, okay? That's everything for today. Hope you enjoyed the lesson and see you again tomorrow, I guess.